Nina, any Munja. Aha, Companies Act 2019 at 992. Okay, for your cobble, a quiet fossil. Or the test you, my Jumane, a quiet fossil power, when a quiet fossil you are. Those attempts are 139.
Yes, 139.
Okay, then relevant portions.
Relevant portions.
Your questions be brave, Busa. Mr. Bernard Acquasizio, no, you are not there, my.
Obey, you are no Nina, Pepper, so. And so Eddie am I think say Enra yeah my background to this information say on the 19th of July John Alote and Associates extra letter ekoma Asamobusu and Co our may the external auditors of Kotoko say the current Kumasa Santé Kotoko board no apa omo say nei omo and omo may the external auditors of the club and unti say auditors omo profession tie no say ye power before for so omna no be adwuma na otro koma the former external auditors ni buso mu se bibisi omu ho kwan professional inti am omu ntimi enye adwuma na awo se ye de ama omu no ana na se bibia da na akwa mu dia na kese de boni fe ne handing over process no etumi astarte eno ena ma asamo bunso na associates so a report asam no ma menhyia se asama abeni ama on the 5th of August Manhyia to echo two letters also a comma got a board and say, Sebi dio mayano, and fa emra quemua, a boo, Manhyia, and imtia, say, a bad way, a see a running commander Santa Coroco. Now, Ocas and Amfa, ye tear for near her for Amfa Act 992, no, which is the Companies Act 2019, no. Now, for specifics, no, yes, starting through 139, no, that is appointment of an auditor, a ho and a this section of the act, you know, a can was a which portion of us a kind for the purposes of this discussion, you know, now intimin kind specifically now, you intimin and coin him.
Okay, okay,
and so we article section 139. I say a person shall not be appointed as an auditor of a company unless that person has before the appointment consented in writing to be appointed and is duly qualified in accordance with section 138, which talks about the qualification of Obia Obetimi Aye Auditor. And a two, no, SA a partnership firm may be appointed in the name of the firm as an auditor of a company. But whether or not,
skip one call.
Yes, skip it and call. Okay, yes, skip it.
141.
Okay, 140. Okay, 140 is about the remunerations of an auditor. The remuneration of an auditor of a company shall be fixed where the auditor is appointed by the directors for the period expiring at the conclusion of the next annual general meeting of the company by the registrar or at the meeting of the company by ordinary resolution of the company or in a manner that a company or ordinary resolution may determine. For the purposes of the full disclosure, no, I was like, the company shall clearly state the financial statements which are accessible and reported to shareholders of the company, the remunerations offered to an auditor of the company for any service rendered, and remuneration payable to an auditor of the company shall be subjected to the confirmation of the members of the company. It is Oko 141. We talked about the removal of an auditor. And I think and I discuss we are in removal of an auditor. Section 141, one they say.
As a kwanya obi auditor.
Now do
directors no almost any
exactly. One they say a resolution to remove an auditor or to appoint any other person in the place of that auditor is not effective unless effectively na auditor be ever auditor for my a written notice has been given to the company of the intention to pass the resolution not less than 35 days before the general meeting at which the resolution is to be moved, and on receipt of the resolution the company has forthwith sent a copy of the resolution to the auditor concerned. B. The resolution is passed at the general meeting of the company. And C. The company has given the members notice of the resolution at the same time and in the same manner as the company gives notice of a meeting. Or, if that is not practicable, has given the members notice of the resolution in the same manner as notices of meetings are required to be given no less than 21 days before the meeting. And to say, PJ, so who read this portion now? And someone can answer, Ansana. Directors be ever more material procrastinate, and also more change, and as a company be ever more material process, almost more change, or more auditors, you know, or about 35 days to the general meeting of the company, you know. So, we'll be informing all the stakeholders, including the auditors now, person, you know. Now, OBI, you to the team say, yeah, come meeting, you know. One of the agenda, you can discuss it, and they say, yeah, but see, yes, it's an auditor, and yes, I'm a paper, and I was away. They're tossing you, know. I was a resolution, no, more personal. Our the general meeting of the company and sana in the company's act, and you have say a demo, so after you me as a auditor, and they talk to me and Sanso. So, no, I was a company, no, and my all the members, no, the resolution, no, sad time now, we inform all the stakeholders, and sad time, no, and you can craft us, no, so prepare
members, no, as any say shareholders,
exactly.
Members in this, no, refers to shareholders.
Shareholders. So, we know we are the members of the company.
Member. And as a shell than ever coupe.
Ever coupe.
Edward two crew re.
Yes.
Crow re. Brary and woman so.
In T.
Because I was a son. That's why they. Obonimani.
Informing it 35 days. And at the end of the day, the process will be complete if or no. In its final resolution, you can say, okay, changing now, I must see you changing now. Majapu.
Any panel crowd, best of you know, the other time. Because I was a trauma in 35 days.
5 days.
No, that's what reaction. You know, throw the amount.
Exactly.
Now, I'm going to call ordinary resolution. Mama, all members.
And your copy. And your copy. Now, Bia could be our team say, Yako discuss the same way. Now, do be our canoe, Waka. You're coming in area. Now, see, you to see a best son. The members of the company, you know, which is the shareholders of the company, you know, will pass the final resolution. I can say, Yajatum, say, if you know, the answer say, external auditors. That should be the process
according to
992. And yes, I did.
Let's go from
a from a man from Nintina on the 5th of August. Me si atro koma board members ne se me se.
What kind of letters ne kakra bia wonya ba ko 139 4 and 5 ne ne kind appointment of auditors no na 139 4 and 5 no 4 ABC ne 5 ABC no kind ne so ye ntia se kwen for so appoint auditors.
Okay, 139 4 as for the purposes of subsection 3, the director may appoint the first auditors of a company and may fill a casual vacancy in the office of auditor. Or if a company does not have an auditor for a continuous period of 3 months, the registrar may appoint an auditor for that company.
Okay.
That is one
appointment. No, say ye be a company for fra.
Yes.
And what num and a directors which may appoint first auditors.
Exactly.
But company holder that year. And no more directors no more juma. What they call what we have for now five. What can you now?
Five.
All your phone.
Yes, my year phone. Five.
He said, 3 months. That's a company be here. You want to move your auditor. Any registrar general now, never appoint you.
Be any amamo.
It is a director. Wait, my appoint you. Be a. Now you say company.
Company. I tell you for fraud.
Exactly. They say Ayala. I will company when say
Ayala and Co.
Ayala and Co. It will be in our first month when you have been any of first directors. Wait, my appoint you first auditor.
Exactly.
Now here and there.
Now after
normal resolution, we need a copy.
Yeah, auditors. They are called. Five for say. And existing auditors are continuing in office until A. That auditor ceases to be qualified for an appointment.
Say, you know that?
That's auditor.
Auditor, I'm going
to call you. And to say, because it's our audit firm, we only qualify BM. Some is some audit firm. B. That auditor resigns from office by notice in writing to the company. An ordinary resolution is duly passed at an annual general meeting in accordance with section 141, removing that auditor from office or appointing any other person in place of that auditor as from the conclusion of the annual general meeting or the tenure of the auditor ends.
I said, "Yeah, Udi can kind."
Exactly.
Yes, I asked
you. Yeah. You see, the
how to remove an auditor from the office.
Yes.
How Udi can idea change him?
Exactly. And I'll be to me, Eddie, you know. And see, that is.
I'm saying, "Oma fum kwan." And the members say, "Nim say, Omi a corporate person, Oma fum kwan." No, and ona ama menjabu afu.
Exactly.
First of all, no, Obi aka se biya. Obi a Oma anyama gini se Omu change you Omu. So me very am letting muka kram the kwan.
Okay. So Oma anyama use Omu change you Omu. Letter May Kanyi was written on the 19th of July. by John Alote and Associates. And social letter now, it is to Mese Asamwabunsu and Co. Chartered Accountant, PO Box KX7909 Kumasi DSA. Appointment of External Auditors Kumasi Asante Kotoko Football Club. This comes to inform you that we, John Alote and Associate, have been appointed as External Auditors of Asante Kotoko Football Club by its Board of Directors as per their letter dated 26th of May 2001. We should therefore be grateful if you could let us know if there are any professional reasons why we should not accept the appointment. Thank you. Yours forcefully. Signed by John Alote and Associates. This letter was received by Asamobunsu & Co. on the 30th of July 2021. And so the letter was written on the 19th and the contents and I'm there too. So it means that on the 26th of May 2021, Anna. Kumasa Sante Kotoko Board of Directors, no, officially, Echo Koma John Alote and Associate for say, yeah, appoint him as external auditors. And almost also on the 19th of July, a proceeded to tell Asamobunsu & Co. say, yeah, appoint you, and TBB or what, move it to me, a catcher.
Yes, yes, yes,
on the 5th of August, 2001.
Nanuye.
Yes, on the 5th of August, and I think 12. Yes, in 2021, on the 5th of August, a letter copied to Mr. Kwame Mensah, Board Secretary, Asante Kotoko Sporting Club Kumasi, DSA. And this letter is on a Manhyia letterhead. External Auditors of Kumasi Asante Kotoko SC. Please refer to our telephone conversation on the above issue last week when you promised to take steps to deal with the reported hindrance of Monsieur Asamobunsu & Co. from conducting their audits. It has now been brought to our attention that another firm of auditors have written to Asamobunsu & Co. claiming to have been appointed external auditors by the board. This development is viewed with the utmost seriousness, both for lack of candor and in particular for its implied affront to the appointing authority. Please be informed that His Majesty Otumfuo 82 remains the sole prerogative for the appointment of directors and the external auditors of Asante Kotoko Sporting Club in his capacity as the sole shareholder of the club. He has not delegated that function to anyone and has no intention of doing so. Asamobunsu & Co. remain the external auditors of the club, duly appointed by His Majesty, and any purported appointment of any other firm by any other body or person to perform the functions of external auditors must be deemed to be nullity. For the avoidance of doubt, please note that His Majesty expects his duly appointed external auditors to be granted unfettered access for the conduct of the club's annual audit, and all concerned must be informed that any attempt to obstruct them hinders them from the performance of their duties will attract severe consequences. Yours truly, signed by Mr. Kofi Bedu, the Chief of Staff of Manhyia, copy to Dr. Kwame Che, the Board Chairman, and Asamobunsu & Co. are Omoye, the auditors of Kumasi Asante Kotoko. Now, PJ, on that same day, on the 5th of August 2021, there was another letter from Manhyia, this time around, to Dr. Kwame Che. Yes. Yes. This time around, this letter was written to Dr. Kwame Che, the board chairman of Kumasi Asante Kotoko. And again, Mr. Kwame Mensah, the board secretary of Kumasi Asante Kotoko. DSA, submission of annual report. Further to my letter of even dates on the external auditors, I am directed to request you to submit your considered pre-audit report for the attention of His Majesty. Given the short time frame between the end of the current season and the commencement of the next season, you will agree that any delay in the audit process could delay consideration of matters essential in the club preparation for the next season. It is to avoid any difficulties this could pose to the club next season that His Majesty has directed that you submit your report for his attention without waiting for the completion of the audit. This will allow His Majesty to consider any matters requiring his attention in due time whilst giving the auditors the ample time they need for their audit. Yours faithfully, Kofi Bedu, the Chief of Staff, also copied Asamoah Gyasi and Co. as the auditors. Let us name
So, yeah, former board member for Asante Kotoko Sporting Club, former National Circles Council Chairman for Asante Kotoko Sporting Club, Mr. Bernard Akosizio. And this season, you know,